My name is Rose Davies, and I used to work as a teacher at Whitehaven Orphanage. I feel like it's been a long time since then. I can barely remember what the place was like. Lately, I've been having dreams that evoke the orphanage. Headaches, anxiety. My therapist, Dr. Tramis, has recommended that I visit the place. He says it might help me sort out my thoughts. Everything seems like a dream to me. Every day, every second. I feel like I'm lost in fog. We're almost there. The lights are on. Is anybody here? I remember this classroom. I used to work here. The crowbar is stained. It looks like dried blood.
Thank you.
I remember the screams, the bruises. God, those poor children. We did all of this. I deserve all of this. It's my fault.
Thank you.
the sewer? My name is Rose Davies, and I work as a teacher at Whitehaven Orphanage. I'm new here. I've only been working at the orphanage for a couple of months. However, it didn't take me long to realize that something was wrong. When I started, I was warned that these children might be troubled or need special treatment because of the things they had experienced. I'd worked with other children of all types before, and knew that the problem these children had was not in their past. My students brought marks and bruises practically every day. They were apathetic and reacted with fear to anything. One day I went to see Dr. Tramis, the doctor in charge of children's health here at Whitehaven. Shortly after speaking with him, my suspicions were confirmed. The children were being abused by the orphanage staff. Dr. Tramis would not name names and said it was best for everyone to keep it all quiet. I couldn't leave things like that. I couldn't. One night, I took the medical files from the infirmary to blow the lid off all this. The watchman must have heard me, and as soon as he saw me with the files, I ran. I left the orphanage and ran. I ran as fast as I could. The watchman was behind me. I couldn't stop to look at him, but I could hear his screams. I ran through the forest to try to lose him, but suddenly, I felt a blow on my head and fell to the ground. My head had never hurt so much. I remember the trees pouring red as the blood poured down my face. Of iron, being dragged through the forest as the branches of the pine trees dug into my legs. A red moon. A manhole cover. And now, I'm here, abandoned. And here I will die. No one will ever read these words or know what happened in the orphanage. Everything is darkening, and the only thing I regret is that I couldn't save those poor children. It's my fault.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.